Let's take a look at this problem that requires creating an indent on a heatsink. This indent is needed to make way for another component, which is represented as a sphere in this case. What you see here is highly simplified for demonstration purposes. If we were to recreate this heat sink from the start, the process would be relatively trivial. We can create the base plate with the indent, followed by the heat fins using the tool object extent option during the extrude. When we pattern, the pattern would honor the tool object extent condition and prevent the fins from going through the indent. However, in this case, the heatsink on hand is from an imported model with no history, so we have no choice but to create the indent after the fins have been created. Although this seems to complicate matters quite a bit, the solution turned out to be quite simple, thanks to the power of the shell command. Take note that the base plate and the fins are of the same thickness, and we want the indent to have the same thickness as well. Let's first create a copy of the sphere. You can go to the bodies folder, right-click on the sphere to copy. And then right-click on the top level and paste. Confirm without moving the copy. Let's name the copy. And hide the original. This is a cross-section of the final result. There is a clearance, followed by the indented wall. To achieve this, I'm going to offset the copy of the sphere by 4 mm. Go to Modify, Offset Face. Select the face of the sphere and adjust the offset distance. Go to Modify, Combine. Select both the heatsink and the copied sphere. Set the operation to Join so that both bodies will merge into one. We do not need to retain the bodies after the operation, so do not check on the Keep Tools option. Go to Modify, Shell. Select these two faces and set the thickness. The command analyzes the thickness of the base and the fins, and will essentially hollow out the sphere accordingly. If we bring back the original sphere, we can see the final result. Let's take a look at a hypothetical scenario where the fin is much thicker than the base plate. In this case, let's assume that the aim of the design is for the indent to be of the same thickness as the base plate. If we use the same method as before and shell, we will end up with this result. Because the fins are much thicker than the base, the shell command has actually hollowed out the fins. This is obviously not what we want. So let's start from the point where we had offset the copied sphere. Take note also that the original sphere is hidden. Go to Modify, Split Body. Select the copied sphere as a body to split. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select this face of the sink. This splits a copy sphere into two. Right-click on the lower half of the sphere and remove. We want to use the remaining portion of the copy sphere to subtract from the sink. Go to Modify, Combine. Select the sink as a target. Select the sphere as a tool. Set the operation to cut. We need to retain this portion of the sphere after the operation, so check on the Keep Tools option. Begin the shell command. And shell this portion of the copy sphere. Go to Modify, Combine. And combine both bodies into one.